Good morning, children. This is video part 1 of lesson number 13, pronouns. In simple language, pronouns are words or phrase that can be used in place of a noun or a noun phrase, and it can perform all the functions that a noun can do. That means it can act as a subject, direct object, and indirect object. Then pronouns also can be used to show possessions. They can also be used to ask questions, point out at objects, and also pronouns can take place of any person, place, animal, or thing. Now the question is, what is the need of pronouns? Why we use a pronoun? We use pronoun to avoid repetition and boring sentences. Children, antecedent is a term associated with pronoun because antecedent is a noun which is replaced by its corresponding pronoun. So, as you can see here, that an antecedent is the noun that the pronoun replaces. You will be able to understand it better with these examples. Maria was lost. She didn't panic. Now, she is replacing actually Maria. So, Maria is antecedent of she. She checked the flashlight. It still worked. It is actually replacing flashlight. So, flashlight is antecedent of the pronoun it. So, the nouns to which pronouns refer is an antecedent. Mr. Tickles normally did not eat fish without organic soy sauce. He decided to make an exception. So, here he is a pronoun. It is replacing the noun Mr. Tickles. So, here Mr. Tickles is the antecedent of pronoun he. Let's see these examples and they'll definitely help you understand exactly what antecedent is. The myth of Arachne is amusing. I enjoyed it. Now, it is replacing the noun the myth. So, the myth is antecedent of it. The second example, the bystanders see Athena. They watch her at the loom. Now, it is very much clear and obvious that they is replacing the noun bystanders. So, bystanders is the antecedent of they, and her is replacing Athena. So, Athena is antecedent of her. Now, these are the 9 pronouns that we'll be studying. Personal, demonstrative, possessive, interrogative, distributive, indefinite, reflexive, relative, and emphatic. All these pronouns you have already learned in 6th standard. I'm sure when we go through these pronouns one by one, you will be able to recollect. First type of pronouns are personal pronouns, and they are used to represent specific people or things. Then they are used depending upon, there are different criteria which decide their usage. First is number. So, there are separate pronouns to replace singular nouns and to replace plural nouns. Now, singular personal pronouns are I, me, you, he, him, she, her, and it. Then, plural pronouns are we, us, you, they, them. Then, they are also classified on the basis of person. First person is I and me, the speaker. Second person, you and you. Third person is he, him, she, her, it. Now coming on to the plural first person pronoun is we and us. Plural second person pronoun you. And plural third person pronouns are they and them. Then also on the basis of gender, masculine, feminine and neuter gender. So I and me are basically common pronouns, means they are used commonly for male and female, both the genders. You also. He and him represent the male gender. She and her are used for female nouns. Then it is used to replace a neuter gender noun. Then when it comes to plural pronouns on the basis of male and female, then we and us both are used for male and female gender. You are used for again both male and female gender. They, them are also used for male, female as well as neuter gender also.
Now, the last classification, that is on the basis of subject and object. Now, subject pronouns will begin the sentences, and object pronouns usually come at the end of the sentence. And another concept is subject pronouns are those which are doer of the action, and object pronouns are those which are receiver of the action. So children, if you remember this table, if you are able to learn, memorize this table, pronouns, personal pronouns are really going to be easy for all of you to understand. Now, one point to notice about, to remember about object pronouns is, they will never be the subject of the sentence, and vice versa means object pronouns will never act as subject and subject pronouns will never act as object pronouns. Now, let us take a few examples to understand subject pronouns and object pronouns. A subject pronoun is used as the subject of a sentence. So, it's going to come in the beginning. She is my best friend. She is the subject pronoun. It is my dog. It is the subject pronoun here. Does he know the answer? Here, he is subject pronoun. You and I will meet later. So, you and I are subject pronouns. Now, let's move on to object pronouns. Object pronouns is used as the direct, indirect object or object of preposition. Give the book to me. Here it is acting as an indirect object. The teacher gave her a reprimand. So her again is being used as indirect object. I will tell you a story. Again, indirect object. Suzanne read it to them. Now here it is the direct object and them is indirect object. Subject pronouns are used in compound subjects and object pronouns are used in compound objects. Basically, subject pronouns will always be a part of subject, whether it is a simple subject or a compound subject. And object pronouns will always be a part of object, whether it is a simple object or compound object. Now, the difference between simple and compound is simple object or subject is made up of one word only, and compound object is made up of more than one word. For example, he and Carmen wrote a report on the subject. Now, he and Carmen together, they form a compound subject. So, we cannot write him in place of he because him is an object pronoun. The second example, tell John and me about Hercules. John and me are compound objects. So, here I cannot replace me with I because I is a subject pronoun. A preposition takes an object just as many verbs do. Prepositions also take object. The object of a preposition can be simple or compound also. In either case, use an object pronoun as the object of the preposition. Since it is object of preposition, we will not use any of the subject pronouns after the preposition. For example, Lee read a famous myth to me, not to I. I will be wrong here. Lee read a famous Roman myth to John and me. Here me is simple object and here it is a part of compound object.
Whenever there is a compound subject and there is a subject pronoun part of it, then the subject pronoun will come after the noun. For example, Lee and I is a compound subject. Okay, so I will come after Lee. So, the correct way to say is Lee and I read some ancient Roman myths. And if you say I and Lee, which is going to be wrong. Similarly, with compound object also. So, in a compound object, the object pronoun will come after the noun. For example, mythology interests Lee and me and not me and Lee. Another rule, in formal writing and speech, we should always use a subject pronoun after a linking verb. Now, what are linking verbs? Linking verbs are all auxiliary verbs or helping verbs like am, is, are, was, were, etc. For example, the writer of this report was she. So, the subject pronoun is coming after linking verb. It is I. After linking verb is I is placed.
Now, these are a few sentences which will help you understand subject and object pronouns clearly. I like coffee. Here, I is the subject. John helped me. Me is the object pronoun. Second, do you like coffee? You is a subject here. John loves you is an object here. He runs fast. Did Ram beat him? He is the subject pronoun and him is the object pronoun. She is clever. She is subject. Does Mary know her? Her is the object pronoun. We went home. We is subject. Anthony drove us. Us is the object. It doesn't work. It is a subject here. Can the engineer repair it? It is an object here. Do you need a table for three? You is acting here as a subject. Did John and Mary beat you at the doubles? It is an object. They played doubles. They is a subject. John and Mary beat them. Them is an object. Now, if you have observed, you and it remain the same whether they are used as subject or an object. Possessive pronouns are those which show possession or ownership, just like possessive adjectives. But there is a difference in the position between possessive pronouns and possessive adjective. What is the difference? The difference is possessive adjectives, they will come immediately before a noun. Whereas possessive pronouns are used in place of a noun, so there is not going to be a noun immediately after a possessive pronoun. These are my books. So here my is possessive adjective because there is a noun immediately after it. Okay. Whereas these books are mine. See, mine is a possessive pronoun because there is no noun after it. And as it is, the difference is very, very clear. My is always used as possessive adjective and mine is always used as possessive pronoun. Second example is, their house is at the end of the street. Their house. There is a noun immediately after their. So it is possessive adjective. The house at the end of the street is theirs. No noun immediately after it. So it is a possessive pronoun. The other difference is T-H-E-I-R, there, and possessive pronouns, most of them end with S. So one thing to remember about possessive pronoun is they never have an apostrophe. They do have an S at the end, but never have an apostrophe. Now just take a look at these two comparative charts. The green one is a pronoun and the brown one is a possessive adjective. Now if you see all of them, that car is mine, yours, his, hers, ours, yours and theirs. All of these are ending in S. Mine and my are the only two possessive pronouns which are different. Possessive pronoun is different and possessive adjective is different. Here, possessive adjectives, that is my car, your car, his car, her car, our car, your car and their car. So there is a noun immediately after these possessive words. Reflexive pronouns are used as an object and they refer back to the subject for which they are being used. So these are pronouns which end in suffix like self or selves. Self we add to singular pronouns and selves we add to plural pronouns. So the sentence loses. Now what is the special feature about reflexive pronoun? It is the sentence loses its meaning if the reflexive pronoun is removed from a sentence. Okay. And on the contrary, if I talk about emphatic pronouns are the pronouns. They also are the same. They are also formed by adding self or selves at the end of the pronouns. But the difference is if you remove emphatic pronouns, the meaning of the sentence remains the same. We'll discuss emphatic pronouns in the next slide. Now examples here are, I can serve myself, they can help themselves. Kim wrote a note to herself, they served themselves last. Now if you remove all of these, myself, themselves, herself and themselves, the meaning of the sentence will be incomplete. Now this is a list of singular reflexive pronouns and this is a list of plural reflexive pronoun. So as I told you earlier, plural reflexive pronouns will have selves and singular reflexive pronoun will have self. Remember this always. One common mistake which people often make is they use their selves thinking it to be a possessive pronoun, whereas it is not. There is no word as their selves. So now reflexive pronouns acts as an object. indirect object also, object of preposition also, and direct object also. These are the three examples where it is performing the role of all the three. Now, let's understand this example. The Carson family tried to lift themselves out of poverty. Themselves is used for the family because family is a plural noun, right? Now, if you remove themselves, the sentence loses its meaning. The Carson family tried to lift whom is the question you want to know. Whom? So, until and unless themselves is there, you will not understand. Ben Carson dedicated himself to becoming a doctor. Ben Carson dedicated whom? This answer we are getting by inserting himself here. Now, important point, reflexive pronoun is always an object. Reflexive pronouns can never act as a subject in a sentence, and they form an integral part of a sentence necessary to the sentence. Emphatic pronouns, as the name suggests, they are used to emphasize. Emphasize what? They are used to emphasize its antecedent. Okay? And unlike reflexive pronouns, they can be used both as subject or object, whereas reflexive pronouns can be used only as an object. Then these are also formed by adding the suffix self or selves to the personal pronouns. Then they are actually reflexive pronouns only, but they are used to emphasize. Emphasize what? The subject in a sentence. And if they are removed from the sentence still makes sense. The examples here are, she herself cooked pasta. Here herself is used as a subject. And if I remove herself, still the sentence will have a good meaning. She cooked pasta. I can understand. Second is, they completed the project themselves. Here themselves is used as an object. I myself saw him. Subject. She herself organized the concert. Here it is used as subject. Now this is a wonderful table which includes subjective pronouns, object pronouns, possessive adjective, possessive pronouns, and reflexive pronouns. So just a glance will help you understand. You can, you know, make a chart on your own and paste it somewhere. In this video part 1, we've learned 4 pronouns, and in the next video, we'll cover the remaining 5 pronouns. Thank you.